Yeah, Rico, they tried to take me for some houseboy. They thought I was just some houseboy. And you know what pisses me off, yeah? I'm going to talk now for real shit, yeah? But some of you men on the roads, yeah? You lot got some man around you. You lot are treating like soldiers. But they are actually proper youths that if you... with proper brains. And you know what was so mad? I'm going to say this and I've never said it before. I came home. I was around a lot of set of different people. But a lot of man thought... Vic's a soldier. I know that. They never said that to me. But a lot of man just thought Vic's a soldier. The hench African youth. People know he's known to knock man out. Man know he's on it. He's got heart. Soldier. And let me tell you where you lot got that soldier story from. And you lot think it's all a soldier thing. And it never was a soldier thing. You lot get it of one. In one situation. And you lot think my man's a soldier. Bro. Yes. Yes. Rest in peace. Sparks. Yes. I was his young G. Yes. Yes, if Andy called me, I was 16. So when you man are hearing this, oh, Vic got sent out by Sparks, I was 16 years old. And the most serious guy in my borough, one of the most serious guys in South London, took me under his tutelage. That tells you how serious he thought I was at 16. Right? So all this Vic was a sent out when I was outside. Up and down on my man, you lot used to see us at the car at the bottom of the road, and a lot of you lot used to run and hop fences. A man didn't even come to do nothing. I'm talking about a brother that you lot with hair man's in the club, and you lot are leaving. When we turn up in places, you lot left. Big men, all this so-called, all of you lot left. Now check it out, for example, now. I'm a 16-year-old. I'm seeing you as a 26-year-old. Shook, frightened at your wits, right? Cool, rest in peace. Now Sparks is dead, yeah? All of a sudden, you want to come out and be gangster now. I'm going to say, no, bro. I know you, fam. I'm going to pull you to the side. Like, yo, fam, I know you, fam. Like, we know each other. Don't do that. That's why a man in my borough can't check me. There's not a check in the borough that can stick on me. It'll bounce. Because I know the thing. I know who's who, who's what, what's who, who's what. Yeah, man's not part of that no more, but I still know. So when I run into some of these guys, I'm not going to let you be a fake version of yourself. I'm always going to remind you, like, brother, I know you. Like, act accordingly. Member. I'm a cloth. I'm one of the members from the cloth. I was here. So I know who's who. I know who's on what, who's not on this. So a lot of other men have heard this story in other sides. Yeah, Vic was, yeah, Sparks. Yeah, Sparks used to send out Vic. Yeah, Sparks used to send. So now you got in your head that Vic's a soldier. Can you imagine? Houseboy. So when I'm around certain people trying to just be supportive and show love, you thought you had a soldier around you. Man thought they had a soldier they could control. And I'm sitting there thinking, and here's the wickedest thing about all these clowns. And they don't know that. Man will say, watch out, you know, be careful when you chill with them man over there, you know, Vic. Like, that's what a lot of man was saying to me. Certain man was saying to me when I come out of job, now, them man there, be careful. But I was saying the whole time, it's the other way around. They need to watch out for me. It's always been the other way around. Because I'm cool being sheep, like sheep in wolf's clothing. I make you just think something else. And guess what? It's only this year that a lot of these same guys that thought man was a soldier, they're realizing that, rah, my man was planning his own thing all along. My man had his own plan all along. They're only realizing it now. They're like, oh shit, my man had his own plan. Of course I had my own plan. You don't think I sat down in jail for 11 years to come out and be someone's soldier? Man think I sat down in 11 years to come out here and let anybody... I got children. I'm the head of my family. I'm my mum's oldest son. You don't think I was ever going to come out and be like... And so this is why some of you lot can't ring my phone again. Because you lot got... Well, you lot thought this was what's going on. You heard a little story from when man was 16. I'm a big man in my 30s right now. So you thought it was still a soldier, the hench African youth, where you heard about. No, bro. This African youth is a chief now. He's an area leader now. You get what I'm trying to say to you? This African youth always been smart. This African youth always had brains. And he said, you get what I'm trying to say to you? This African youth is always been in control. Do some double check some shit. Check with the man them on the landing. They will tell you, this African youth knows how to move. I am the guy that I make it move. I make the wheel spin and I make it move without me, you knowing. Because I was trained a certain type of way. We don't talk, you know what I'm saying? We don't talk up our thing. So guess what right now? Man's the area leader of the slums, period. So you see some of you guys, if you guys want to get involved, don't DM me about doing a tune. I don't want to do a tune. Some of the charitable causes that man's behind, why don't you pledge something to it? Then I'll know you're serious. You want to get involved in what I'm doing right now? Hit up one of them charities. Psychology, or hit up Hackney Wicks or Bobby, or hit up Farron Pool, hit up Forever Family, hit up some of them organizations where we are the last line of defense. Hit them up and get involved in it. Don't come on the clout thing. Let's get in the studio. Man's not getting in the studio with you, bruv. Go hit up one of them charities man's working with. Put something on the table. Put your hand in your right pocket. We'll know you're serious. Don't come over here for some clout trying to get a Vic Santoro verse. No, bro. That's not where the clout is. You know what I'm saying? Because I know that's why a lot of you don't want clout. You want to put the picture up so you can say, no, we're not doing that. Get involved in some of them charities man's dealing with. Yeah? Sometimes when man pull up on the block, pull up. Let's reason with the young youth. The further my summer's coming, let's put some peas together and send these youths on a Ross Clark theme park trip or arrange couple trips. You man in the borough want to get involved in what Vic's doing? Bring your hand, put something on the table. Don't come with your dry hands trying to get clout, trying to stand next to man. No, bro, we are not doing that. You want to show me you're sorry about how you moved before? You want to show me that you're a different person now? Come, there's loads of charities. There's loads of things going on. Let's do that. Fuck this whole, I'm not on that. There's loads of doing that. My charity, we've committed to two projects a year in Africa. Right now, we're trying to put tables and chairs in a school in Nigeria. Get involved, bro. No matter what part of the industry you're involved in, Vic Santoro's number, you can get your hand on it if you really want it. You can get, someone can plug you in and you know what I'm saying? I'm reachable. It's the area leader. I am the area leader. You guys said of the slums, so you can reach me. Don't nobody message me again about songs. Let's get in the booth. The fake. Don't call me bro either again. You want to be a bro? Become a member.